We have learned the working principle of bug topology. So you must ask, what kind of constraints does the switch mode converter has? And in other words, what kind of mathematical equations should the switch converter satisfy? So in today's subsection, we will analyze the two operation modes of bug converter. So we will mainly talk about the inductor current of the bug converter. So we have learned that for the bug converter, based on the switch pulse position, we can have two operation modes, right? Now let's look at those two modes one by one. So first, mode one. For mode one, we have the switch attached to point one. So we can plot its equivalent circuit accordingly. So we have the input source, VG. And switch is pushed to position one. So we have this is VS. And on the right-hand side, we will have the low-pass filter network, which is L and C here. And of course, we have a load resistor. So again, let's mark those electrical quantities like the inductor current, ILT. And we mark the polarity of the inductor voltage as VL. So positive is on the left. And also here is the capacitor current, ICT. And here is the output voltage, Vs. So based on this equivalent circuit, we can look at the profile of this inductor voltage. So Vl, based on Kirchhoff voltage law, we can easily analyze the voltage across Vl by the input voltage and output voltage. So this equals to input voltage minus output voltage. And in the previous subsection, we learned that we have small ripple approximation on the capacitor voltage. So we can apply the principle here, right? So VL will be approximately equals to DC input voltage minus DC output voltage, which is capital letter V. Okay. Correspondingly, we can plot the waveform for VLT versus time in the operation mode one from zero to DTS. So this will be a DC quantity as VG minus V. So for the inductor, we know that we have the inductor voltage and current following the principle like inductor voltage equals to inductance times the derivative of inductor current over time, dt. So based on this inductor current voltage relationship, we can derive that di over dt equals to vl over inductance. And this vl equals to this quantity. So since this quantity is a positive number, it means that the inductor current will rise linearly at the slope of this quantity. So correspondingly, we can also plot the inductor current waveform IL. In operation mode 1, from 0 to DTS. So our analysis shows that the current will be rising linearly. The rising slope equals to Vg minus V over L. So that's the profile for mode 1. Next, let's look at operation mode 2. For mode 2, the switch is attached to position 2, so we can also construct its equivalent circuit correspondingly. So the Vs is shorted to the ground. So Vs equals to 0. And here is L, C, R. Similarly, we mark the quantities like I L T V L I C T V S. So for operation mode 2, we can also construct the inductor voltage equation by the KVL principle. Equals to. So KVL tells us that this voltage just equals to inverting of output voltage. Similarly, the small ripple approximation tells us that this quantity can be approximately equals to average output voltage minus V out. And we can similarize what we did here. We can also write the inductor current equation. So this quantity equals to VL over L. And for operation mode 2, this equals to minus V over L. So this is a negative number. So this means that in operation mode 2, we can also construct the voltage and the current waveform. Like from DTS to TS. So the inductor voltage equals to minus V. Correspondingly, the inductor current will decrease linearly. And at the rate of minus V over L. So that's the switching waveform of inductor voltage and current over one switching period. Right? And for the next switching period, it is going to repeat again and again. Similarly, the current will rise linearly. Now let's look at the inductor current waveform. So we can denote a DC quantity here, which is the average value of inductor current. So based on the average value of the inductor current and the peak value of inductor current, we can introduce a quantity, which is the current ripple. So here we define delta IL as inductor current ripple. So we define that the current ripple equals to the distance between the current and the peak current. So this is delta IL. OK, so based on this definition and the waveform here, we can see that delta IL equals to the net increase of inductor current in this region. This region counts as half of the mode 1. So we can write the expression for delta IL equals to the slope of the current changing rate, right? So which is Vg minus V over L times half of mode 1 length, which is dTs divided by 2. So based on this inductor current ripple definition, we can conclude that L equals to minus V over 2 delta IL times dTs. So this tells us how should we design the value of inductance when we design the buck converter. Okay. So till now, we have analyzed the buck circuits, inductor currents, and also we have defined the inductor current ripple for the buck converter.